tardes, mi linda gente. Bienvenidos a nuestro canal Cocinando con Marta y Darlene. Si no se ha inscrito a nuestro canal, hágalo, es totalmente gratis. Regálenos un like y active su campanita para que le lleguen nuevos videos.
Thank you. Hello, everybody, for watching today. Today, we are going to bring you some treats. We thank you for watching us wherever you're watching around the world. Let us know where you're watching us from today. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please do so. Hit the little alert bell there and notification so that you are alerted for our next video as well. And subscribe to our channel so we can bring you more of these wonderful videos.
Hoy le vamos a traer dos recetas que estamos haciendo para Navidad, como un flan napolitano y una torta de leche nicaragüense.
So we're going to bring you two treats, two desserts, Christmas themed here today. One is going to be a flan and the other one is going to be what we call back home, torta de leche, and it's like a bread pudding type of dessert today.
La receta del flan, vamos a poner a 7 huevos aquí. Los vamos a licuar.
7 eggs. 7 eggs that we are going to put into our blender.
También vamos a poner 8 onzas de queso crema.
8 ounces of cream cheese.
Si usted no lo quiere hacer con queso crema, solo lo puede hacer con huevo y la leche condensada y la leche evaporada.
If you don't like cream cheese, you don't have to use it, but it just gives it a nice creamier taste and texture. But you can also do it without and just use the eggs and the condensed milk and the evaporated milk.
También estamos poniendo leche con condensada, 400 gramos.
Yep, so it's 400 grams of condensed milk.
Ayúdame para sacar esto.
Okay. I want to scrape as much or all possible.
También vamos a poner leche evaporada, 354 de leche evaporada.
This is the evaporated milk, so it's one can, so it's 354.
Vamos a poner una cucharadita de canela.
All in there, we're going to also use some cinnamon, one teaspoon of cinnamon in there.
También vamos a poner dos cucharaditas de esencia de vainilla.
So this is vanilla essence, 2 teaspoons.
Y ahora lo vamos a licuar.
You can already smell it. It smells so good.
Ok, ahorita ya la vamos a poner en el sartén porque la vamos a hacer a baño María. Aquí tenemos el caramelo. Si usted quiere con caramelo y si no, solo le puede poner de esta mantequilla. Le vamos a poner alrededor en que no se pega, pero por si acaso le vamos a poner alrededor de.
So this here is the finished, it's all blended. We are going to pour it in here. At the bottom here, you'll see that we have the caramel in there, already caramelized. This was just sugar and water, and we just let it low temperature to caramelize. And then we put butter around the edges too. If you don't want or you don't like the caramel on top, then you can just use the butter and just pan, use the butter along the pan there, but we are going to
ahora lo vamos a tapar con
use
papel
the caramel.
De aluminio bien.
And we also greased it around the edges. It won't stick, but just in case, we also greased around there. And now we're just going to cover it with aluminum foil.
Tiene que estar bien tapadito que no se le vaya a meter agua. Lo vamos a poner por 1 hora y 20 minutos.
Pero go in the oven for 1 hour and 20 minutes.
Pero antes, cuando ya tenga 1 hora, lo vamos a ver. Porque depende también de su horno. Lo vamos a poner a 350 en alto.
Ok. So it's going to go on to 350 degrees.
Tiene que ver como 2 pulgadas que le llegue el agua calientito. Tiene que ser en una cosa más grande para que.
So you can see.
Está bien.
It is in a larger, rounder pan, and there's water in there. So you want to make sure that it's about 1.5 to 2 inches of water in there, just to make sure that you don't get water inside the pan too. And you can see that there's still some space there.
Ahorita le llevamos al horno.
Okay, there it's going in the oven.
Ahorita vamos a hacerle también otra receta de la torta de leche que hacemos en Nicaragua. Y aquí la tenemos remojada, 2 libras de pan francés, del que ya se le hace duro o puede ser fresco, pero de todas maneras usualmente lo hacemos con el pan que sobre, que se hace un poco duro. Tenemos 2 libras de pan y tenemos ahorita 5 tazas de leche.
Okay, so this is our next dessert we're going to make. This is going to be the bread pudding. And this is from bread that you can use, like that's already been maybe sitting a couple of days. It's about 2 pounds of bread in here, and there's 5 cups of milk, and we have it here sitting already in the milk for a little bit. So it's just gonna soak up all the milk right now. That's what it's doing in there.
Para empezar la torta de leche, esta es muy riquísima, la vamos a hacer al baño María. También está de otra manera de hacerla, de varias formas. También la podemos hacer al horno y que queda muy tostada arriba, pero yo la quiero hacer a baño de María también.
Okay, so we are ready to start the bread pudding. We are not going to be using the oven for this dessert. We have in the oven the flan, but we are actually going to be doing a different technique. We are actually going to be making it over the stove. So you can see back here, we have already started heating up the water, and we are going to be putting in our dish with the bread pudding inside, and you're going to see how it's going to turn out. It's not going to be toasted or baked. It's going to actually be really nice, moist, and tender.
Se puede poner un guante o con su mano bien limpita, porque también la podemos hacer en la licuadora, pero hoy no tengo ganas para que queden algunos pedacitos de pan. También la vamos a endulzar con leche condensada.
So here we're, she's going to actually mix it up and break the bread apart with her hands. You can use the blender, but because we want it with some little bits and pieces in there, give it some texture, we are just going to be breaking it and mixing it in with the hands.
También le vamos a poner 4 onzas de margarina, no margarina, sino
butter,
mantequilla.
That's 4 ounces of butter in there as well. I'm going to use as much as
possible.
Dos cucharadas?
Yeah, 2 cucharadas.
We are adding cinnamon, so 2 tablespoons of cinnamon.
Ponemele 2 cucharadas de vainilla.
We're going to use 2 as well, tablespoons of vanilla essence in here. Two tablespoons of essence of vanilla, vainilla, la canela, ya le echamos.
También vamos a usar 4 huevos, también vamos a usar 1 lata de leche condensada, también vamos a usar 1 cucharadita de
polvo de hornear.
Polvo de hornear.
I'm gonna put in the right now the baking powder in here. And then half a teaspoon actually of salt there. We're having the evaporated milk, and we're actually gonna add as well 4 eggs, but I'm going to go put them into the blender first. We have added some of the bread pudding mixture in here just so that we don't have too many clumps in the mixture. So we're just going to mix it up with the eggs in there.
Ahorita mezclamos con los huevos la mitad de este pan para que no nos quede tan fino y tampoco no nos quede pelotas así, sí, muy gruesas.
You can see a difference there. See, we mixed some of the batter in there, just so that we don't have it all very clumpy. I'm gonna mix it in with the rest.
Le pusimos 600 gramos de leche condensada porque no le echamos azúcar, solo le endulzamos con la leche condensada.
So we didn't use any sugar in this recipe. All we used was the condensed milk in here.
Le vamos a echar también una taza de pasas.
Okay, so we're gonna add as well 1 cup of raisins.
La vamos a ir viendo si necesitamos más, si le gusta más, pues le puede poner más, taza y media.
Okay, so 1.5 cups of the raisins.
We are haciendo el caramelo.
Making the caramel for it. You can use the caramel for at the bottom of the pan, or if you don't like the caramel, which is just sugar and water, you can just grease your pan with some butter. But we are going to add some of the caramel to our pan. And here you can still see that the water is warming up there.
Nuestro caramelo está cambiando de color. Mire, aquí ya se le pone bajo la temperatura para que no se le vaya a quemar, porque si se le quema queda amargo.
So you can see here that our caramel is starting to change color. So you want to make sure that you don't have it on high heat, because you don't want it to burn either, because then it's just not gonna, it's gonna be like burnt sugar. You're not gonna actually taste any of the caramel, the sweetness in it.
Ya está la miel que le vamos a echar el caramelo, con mucho cuidado, porque una quemadura de con miel, oh, es terrible.
Okay, so this is our caramel that it's done. We just have to be very, very careful because it is extremely hot and you won't want to burn this, because a burn from this is very dangerous as well.
Ahora lo vamos a poner aquí.
Drizzling it over the pan. I had just finished greasing it, the edges of the pan with butter. Okay. Okay, we're gonna spread it around.
Bueno, solo a la orilla le pusimos un poquito de mantequilla para que no se vaya a pegar. Okay. Y ahora la vamos a poner allí. Y como nos va a sobrar, vamos a hacer otro aquí. Pero a este no le vamos a poner caramelo, solo la margarina. Poner un poquito más de margarina allá abajo.
So here, because we have some extra, we're gonna grease this one. We're not gonna use any caramel in this one. We're just gonna have the butter. And this one is gonna go into the oven. Small one here.
Bueno, vamos a sacarle lo más que podamos. Ahora lo emparejamos un poco. Lo golpeamos para que se empareje.
Just make one, make sure it's even out.
Le vamos a poner un poquito de pasas más encima.
Okay, just some extra raisins onto the top part of our bread pudding. You can smell, I know you can't smell over the video, but you can smell it. It smells good.
El olor es delicioso y le ponemos unas cuantas pasitas allí. Lo vamos a dejar por 45 minutos, pero lo vamos a ver antes, unos 30, a ver cómo va.
So we're going to put that in for 45 minutes, but about around the 30-minute mark, we are going to take a look and check it out to see how it's cooking. Okay. Then we're going to put more tin foil at the top as well. And we just want to make sure that we are checking it so the water level remains the same. Using the tin foil, we want to make sure that it's really tightly sealed so that it is cooked with the water vapor as well.
Y este lo vamos a meter al horno.
And then the small one is going to go into the oven.
Okay. Ahorita estamos esperando los postres que se hagan, los tenemos adentro del horno. Cuando ya estén, se los vamos a enseñar al final cómo van a quedar de ricos. Si usted no se ha inscrito a nuestro canal Cocinando con Marta y Darlín, hágalo porque es gratis, regálenos un like y active la campanita para que le lleguen nuevos videos.
So we have now completed our two different desserts. They're in the oven and up here that is cooking in the water bath there. It's going to be about another 45 minutes, but we just want to remind you, if you haven't subscribed yet to our channel, Cooking with Martha and Darlene, you can do so now. It's free. And hit the alert notification button so you're notified of our next videos. And if you have any recipes or any comments, or anything that you would like to see in the future videos, let us know. Post them in the comments and we'd like to read those as well. Thank you so much.
También déjenos saber si usted conoce la torta de leche con algún otro nombre. También déjenos saber de qué país es usted y a lo mejor tiene diferentes nombres. Algunos le dicen budín. Pero nosotros le llamamos en mi país torta de leche.
Yeah, so if you're watching this and it looks like something that you make in your country, let us know what it's called, what you guys call it there. For us, we call it torta de leche. Here, it's bread pudding. Maybe in your country, it's called something else. Let us know what the names are.
Aquí quedó nuestro producto ya terminado. Aquí está el flan. Usted lo puede poner o sea más grueso. Nosotros lo hicimos un poco ralo. También aquí está la torta de leche, esta la hicimos al baño María y esta la metimos al horno. Así es que vamos a probarlo cómo quedó. El olor está delicioso.
They smell wonderful. This is the final product of our desserts for this evening. We have here the flan. You can make it, ours was relatively thinner, about an inch. Just depends on the type of, or how deep your dish is that you're going to make it in. We have the bread pudding here. This was the one that came out from the oven, and we have the one here that we did it over in the water bath over top of the stove here. So we're just gonna get ready to give it a taste, and the smell is just delicious.
Esta yo me la puedo comer todavía está un poquito caliente.
This one didn't, we didn't let it cool down as much as the other ones did, but oh my goodness, you can see how like jelly it is. It's not hard, it's pretty soft, it's moist.
Así nos quedó la torta de leche que metimos al horno por 45 minutos. Lo mismo le dimos a este 45 minutos.
We're in for 45 minutes. The only difference is this was made over the stove. So we're just gonna cut these slices here. And you can see. Okay.
La contextura está más suave este.
This is a little more jelly, more softer than this one here. This is more a little bit more solid. But they're both delicious. The smell is the same. It's just really, really tasty.
Ahora vamos a cortar. Este lo podemos cortar por la mitad. Oh, está delicioso este.
This one is very... I think this one was the one that made... When we put it in, the smell was like almost instant.
Este es el flan, riquísimo está. Ok, vamos a sacar un pedacito para probarlo. Oh, my goodness.
Look at that. That is like perfect. This is perfect. You can see it's jelly. Look how spongy it is. It looks creamy. It's smooth inside. This is how you would want to have your flan.
Okay.
And we are ready to give these a taste. I'm very excited to try this one.
Oh my goodness.
I am a big fan of flan, and this
delicioso.
Yes, this is so good.
Ahora vamos a probar este. Yo creo que sí me gusta mejor porque lo veo como más suave.
Okay, this is the one that was on top of the stove there. This is the bread pudding. It's still quite warm, but this is really good.
Los dos están deliciosos. Si usted no lo ha hecho, pruébelo. Déjenos en los comentarios si a ustedes le llaman de alguna otra manera en su país. Si usted no se ha suscrito a nuestro canal Cocinando con Marta y Darlene, hágalo ahorita mismo porque es totalmente gratis. Regálenos un like si le gustó este video y también active su campanita para que le lleguen nuevos videos. Que Dios me los bendiga y buenas noches. Que pasen una feliz Navidad y un próspero año nuevo.
Thank you so much for watching and tuning in this evening to our video today. We are done now. We've tasted it. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. And let us know in the comments if you make these types of desserts, what you call them back home. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please do so. It's free. It's Cooking with Martha and Darlene. We would love for you to hit the like and get your alerts, your notifications set to on so you can be alerted of our next video. God bless, and we hope that you have a great holiday time wherever you are watching from. Thank you so much.